Or maybe we presume that you will be tired of it. But anyway, so originally Varnams were like this. Most of the old Varnams. Now here there is another small issue. There are two kinds of Varnam we talked about. We talked about Tana Varnam, we talked about Pada Varnam. Anybody heard those words? Now that anybody who has knows the difference between Pada Varnam and Tana Varnam?
Dance
and music.
Pada Varnam should have linguistic meaning also coming out of Nikaisa.
Thank you for telling me. I was waiting for that answer. No, no, I want to, that is the normal perception. That's absolutely a wrong perception. No, I wanted, I thought the same thing. You're not in the minority. I thought same thing for it. He basically said that for a Tana Varnam, you had meaningful lyrics here, right? And this was just Varnam. These were just words. For a Pada Varnam, Pada also means Pada. All this should also have Pada. Seems very logical. This is what everybody has been saying and are still saying. But I am willing to say to everybody who says it that they are wrong. The history is very different. Originally, the first Varna form that came was the Tana Varna form. Okay? From it, a revolute of it was a Pada Varna. Now, the difference between the two Varnams is not the existence of the Sahitya. There are Tana Varnams in which there is Sahitya from the service. There is a Natakurji Varna. Everybody will say it's a Pada. You know what the difference between the two forms? The Pada here does not refer to Pada as a word. It refers to Pada as in Pada as a musical form, which we now refer to as Padam also. Pada. So the melodic movement in a Pada Varnam, which was also called a Chauka Varnam, which means a slow Varnam, was fluid. The Tana Varna melodic movements are rigid and stiff. For example, when I sang Sarra Suda, can you see the construction? So there's a rigidity. I'll sing a Pada Varna now. The difference between these two Varnam is in the aesthetic use of this. Tana Varnams in the old original form also had Sahitya or lyrics or Pada for Mukta Iswaram and all those areas. So Natakuri Chalam is a Tana Varnam. It's not a Pada Varnam. Pada Varnam is when it resembles the Pada as a form, as a musical form. Okay? So that distinction we have to understand is more a musical distinction than a distinction from having lyrics or not having lyrics.
Pada and Tala or Tana?
Tana. Some people say there is an improvisation technique called Tanam singing, which is a rigid, kind of a stiff technique. If you notice, the Tana Varnam uses a very similar technique. So they say that the Tana Varnam resembles, it's called a Tana Varnam because it resembles that form of, that's also one of the interpretations that people
say. The same term that you're about to articulate.
That's the Tanam. So it resembles a kind of rigidity that there is there. No? That marking of every syllabic or every swara movement. That staccato feeling is there in the Tanavarna. It's not there in the Padavarna. Padavarna is far more fluid. It flows.
So does that make it more suitable for dance interpretation?
Probably does. But Tanavarnams also could be danced. Not that they cannot be. But what happens is because you sing it with this rigid thing, expansion of it becomes very difficult even musically. Even purely musically, an expansion of a Tana Varna, it becomes difficult because I have to be honest to the aesthetics of the form. I have to keep to that structure. In a Pada Varna, I have the flexibility or the fluidity of movement. So even for dance, if I was going to render a Pada Varna, it's easier. Because the movements are far more fluid. So Padavarnams are used more in dance, but Padavarnams are not the first forms. The first forms were Tanavarnams. And from Tanavarnam came
Padavarnam. Padam itself goes back
to Padam as a form actually goes back to 1400s. Let me go back. When is Vijayaraghavan Act 1600, 1500s?
But no difference in
late, I would say, let me say. I think the Marathas came to Tanjore around 1660. Vijayaraghavanayaka, I would say from about at least late 1500 to 1600, because we know Kshetrajna, who composed Rajya Pada, visited Madurai and Tanjore. So it must be early 1600. So it really predates a lot.
Varnam also has.
I found that many Varnams, almost predominantly most Varnams, also find the Ritya Akshara Prasadam locally. You see Rahi sometimes, but you will find it following. Most Varnams, Padams, most of them seem to have. There are always, remember, exceptions to all this.
Can you please substantiate using what you sang, the first Varnam, and tell us the Dviti Akshara?
What's Rasa? What Varnam? Yeah, Dviti Akshara is very clear.
Sarasura.
I say Ra and Ri they have used here. Sarasura, Giri.
Ra and Ri.
Yeah. Vanajakshiro, Vanare, Anupallavi. Jalajaksha, Chela, Anupallavi. Inta Modi, Chenta, Anupallavi. Yera Napai, Ra and Ru here is used. Yera and Maru. Okay?
So how is Maru?
Not the first, second syllable. Second syllable, you are missing the first syllable. Second.
Second
syllable, okay? They have used La and Ru here. Valachi, Chelu, Ru. You find most of the Varnams, you find it. Sami, Bhumi. I'm just flipping through and just reading out. Inta Chauka, Panta Mela. Inta Panta. Most Varnams we follow it. Again, Sami and Bhumi. And Varnams are very repetitive in Sahitya. They say the same things again and again. Sarasija, Paramatma. Sara, Para. You find it. Just flip through it, you will find it. Most of it works. Karunimpa, Parula.
No.
See, first of all, I think we have to take it out of our head that Varnam is some exercise. It's an art music creation. I think we should give it a little more respect. That's my honest opinion. We don't seem to. To sing a Viriboni is not a joke. It can take every bit of your energy, mental, emotional, physical, all. Because there is so much in it. So it's not about prepping myself for anything. It's really an art music creation. Whether it's a Tanavarnam or a Padavarnam.
No.
So, the biggest challenge in a Varna is the fact that there are very little lyrics. If you notice, the gaps between every syllable are huge. This is not exercise. This is magnificent melodic creation. Next syllable was after 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can't breathe in between. You could see this. It's magnificent.
So did old poetry have such structure actually?
Actually the poetry for the Varnams was very simple.
No, I'm saying Tamil poetry or Telugu poetry, like the haiku has, it's very fixed, right? So was that the reason why it happened this way?
What happened?
The second syllable has to match.
I possibly it came from Tamil poetry.
Okay.
From some habit in Tamil poetry that they followed it. I really don't know how it came into musical context. But the people who seem, everybody seems, and Puranadasa has used it, Anamacharya has used it, Tyagaraja has used it, everybody has used it. The thing is, it's very prevalent. Now, why couldn't you have great poetry in music without Yakshar Prasad? You probably can. I'm not saying. But it is important that it's an important indicator for us in this form. Especially, you know, in terms of form understanding, it gives us a lot of indication. You know, I'm able to place looking at a single lyrics, whether I'm looking at Anupali or a Charanam. So if I was going to melodically look at something, I have perception of what it is. That's all I'm trying to say. But it's prevalent in almost every form. So the Varnam is really a creation of just melody. And the Sahitya in the Varnam is hardly anything. Viri Boni, that's all I said. Whenever I finished Ni, I had lost my breath. Right? So the Varnam has very little syllables, I mean the Sahitya. So every vowel is extended. Everything is moved. Absolutely, you learn that the whole identity of the raga and the varnam is brilliant. The kirtana is a different case. I just move to one form which is close to this form. See, there is something called swarajati. You all hear that word.
Yeah. This
varnam
is another form like
kirtana,
right?
Yes,
I'm
not talking about kirtana here. Yeah.
No, it's another form.
It's a form. It's a composition.
And can you say that since the Sahitya content of Varnam, I think from what you said, it's relatively lesser than in other forms. Can you say that gives the singer more scope for abstraction?
An interesting point. I'm not too sure about it because the Tana Varnam, though it does not have lyrics, it has a structure that makes it very limiting. That I have to follow that structure or makes it less liberal. I'm not very sure you could say that. Most of the lyrical content of Varnams is Shringara. 99.9% of Varnams is Shringara. It's all erotic and romantic poetry, complete. There is one or few of them which is bhakti. Everything else is okay for that. Okay? The Varnam may be as old as about, the oldest Varnam may be early 1700. Yeah, early 1700 will be the oldest Varnam. Around that period of time. There is one form, Swarajati. I'm going to give you two interpretations of Swarajati. First, not the one you are very familiar with. You saw this Varnam form, right? The Swarajati is a kind of a, looks, could have been a precursor to this. Some people say it may have been before the Varnam. It does small changes. It also has a Pallavi, similarly. It also has a Anupali, similarly. Here, it plays around with Jati. The word Jati indicates all the syllabic sounds of rhythm. Ketatom, Tam, Tai, all these things. Okay? In the Muktai Swar area, the Swarajati usually starts with about two avartanas of Hindi Jatis in melodic form, not reciting but sung, followed by some swarams. Then, maybe one line of Jati again, which links back to the Pali. This form of Swarajati, if any of you have followed dance, will see a lot of this form of Swarajati. I'll just sing for you a flash of one Swarajati. I think I have it here, I hope so. The very famous Swarajati in Hussein. So, obviously these forms were used for the dance. I mean, that's a giveaway. So, it's almost the same form if you noticed. Except for the fact that this has one jati here and syllabic sounds here, it goes back. Similarly, it has a charanam also. And the charanam also has two lines. This charanam is very famous. Aura Aura Bhagayam Revila saroja shivala valalodagina heranumari chiriyaurura bagayamare nigala saroja shivalodagina heranumari chiriyaurura Then, this is Sahitya also. This is a very famous Swarajati. Swarajati is a dance, very popular. And it's very old creation, it's not a new creation, very old creation. So this form, it seems to be very close to the Varnam form. Just the same Charan you have Swaram, like for example, you could also have Satyan, but here you, all the Swarams have a lyrics below, everyone. But the form is more or less the same. It's not very, so there is a possibility that the Swarajati actually gave way to Varna. One person we have to remember here, we forget unfortunately, is Melattu Veerabhadraya. He's probably one of the greatest geniuses we had in South Indian Carnatic music composition history. Probably the first composer who ever composed the Swarajati. Probably the first composer who ever composed the Tillana in South India. Probably the first composer who ever composed the Ragamalika. One of the oldest composers who ever composed the Ragamalika. We don't even know his name. His contribution is something immense. Especially today in context of even Bharatanatyam music, because Swarajati Varnam's all. First Tillana that we see in South India is It's on these manuscripts are available. Saraswati Maha Library, Tanjore. They're available. So, then you have the other kind of Swarajati, which you may have heard definitely, Shama Shastri's Bhairavi Kamakshi. Or even, for example, the Swarajati. Why we call it Swarajati is a good question, but we come to that. This Swarajati is very different. This second Swarajati seems to have been pretty much Shama Shastri's creation. That is that famous composition of this. Even those who don't know about it, don't worry. This has a very simple structure. It has a Pallavi. Kamakshi Amba Anudinamu Maravakare Deepalamra Deepadamula Deekanu Tsunamu Then, Then he comes to charanas. Yes, no, this composition form does not have an anupali. You have charanas, but they are not just charanas. You have seven charanas, or eight actually. And this composition form insists that every charanam must start on the next swara as per the arohana of the raga. So Kamakshi Swarajati is like this. This is the form. And every swaram has lyrics.
So it's really not just a varnam is talking
about varnam? No, it's not necessary. This is specific of this swarajati. There are two swarajatis, two forms of swarajatis. One, the dance variety, second, this. And this seems to be Shava Shastri's genius. In Todi, Todi is a problem. Todi is a problem case. Take Yadukal Kambodhi.
Sari sari ma aga sari ma gari pa
sari second also starts with sari
sari pa ma ga sari ma gari sa sari ri pa
third
ri sari pa ma ga sari sa ni da pa ga then ri pa ma ma ga gari ri then Ma pa ni da ma ba ta pa ma ga ri pa ma pa ni da pa ma ga ri da pa ma ga ri ma ga. Sa ba da. Sari da sa ga ri sa ni the last row.
So if you notice, sa ri ma pa da sa. He may have repeated two swarams on sa and two swarams on ma, or two swarams on ri also, but he has still gone on that. The Todi is a third creation of Shyama Shastri. There are a lot of scholars who question the authenticity of that swarajati on the basis that it does not work. The swarams don't seem to fall in this structure at all. So some scholars do question that could have been somebody else, because in the other two he has done it, or it could have just been he didn't feel like doing it with that. So, we have to probably let that be too. But even now, one of the reasons why, for example, even Ravenu Gopapalara could be called a swarajati is because it has, though it does not follow this structure, it follows this more or less.
Rajita Sarguna Jaya Shiva Sarasa Chameva Venida La 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 Sarave Nubro Papa La Rajita Sarguna Jaya Shiva Pa Asari Gaga Vigapa Nanda Rupa Papa Magadigada Magadigapa Magadigapa Papa.
All those have Swarasahita Swarasahita, let them going back to Rarabe. So could be, that's why we refer to it as Swarajati, but that's, I don't know, that could be. But the Shyama Shastri Swarajati, at least the two out of the three, are brilliant at following this structure. And it's not just about following this structure, it's about how he has used, I mean, it's not just about composing on Swaram and Sahu, okay, second, three, third, ga, no. It's slightly deeper than that. It's about how he has actually created a musical edifice using that. And it's really extraordinary. Extraordinary, honestly extraordinary. So these are two swarajatis. Now I'll come to the most important form. Though I'd like to, I'll trace back, but I'll come to this. This whole kirtana. Now the word that we love to use is kriti, rather than kirtana. Does anybody know there's a difference between kirtana and kriti? You all heard the word kirtana, you all heard the word kriti. Some people say kirtana is this, but kriti is that. That is kirtana, this is kriti, I'm wondering. Some people will say kirtanas are those devotional rendition compositions that are sung for devotional music. Kriti is the art music creation. That is also, I think, our own adjustment that we've done. Technically, the word should be kirtana for this form. But if you're using kriti, there's no difference. As long as we are aware that using kirtana and using kriti is not really different, then it doesn't make a big. I prefer using the word kirtana than kriti. The kirtana is today the most popular composition form that we have in Carnatic. We have to just accept that. Now, why is it? Is a very, very important question. There could be multiple answers. We'll try and address some of them. The kirtana has basically a melody like any other composition. Could be two lines. Usually, all these are usually, there are always exceptions. Could be one line, one avartana, could be two avartanas, four avartanas, rarely three, but very rarely. Usually there is also a relationship between the number of avartanas to the Pallavi and the Pallavi chara. If the Pallavi is one avartana, the Anupallavi usually be two avartanas, the Kanna will be four avartanas. If the Pallavi is two, this will be four, this will be even eight, sometimes even 12. Usually there is a relationship. But this does break down sometimes. Doesn't always work. Okay? And that doesn't make, importantly, there are some musicians who don't like composition with three avartanas. I think, how can they make three? No, I think that's a ridiculous question. Because it's not about getting the math right again. It's not about getting the math right. It's about the fact that melodically, it has a form in three avartanas. So we just leave it as it is. So there have been cases where, I think one case I'll sing and show you. A composition all of you would have heard. Even I sing it like this. Nanupa limpa harichi vachitivo. Okay? Mohan Raga. We sing it like this. Nanupa limpa radachi vachitivo gona pranana da. What is that? It is an addition made. Because we want to fit it in to two Kalai Adi Kala. If I sang the same song in Uru Kalai Adi, it will come in three avartanas. Nan, nanu pa, pa, nadachiva chiti vo, na, pranana, na, nanu pa. It's all over. But since we put it in Rindu Kalai Adi Kala, which doubled the kalam, you need an even number. Right? You need even number. So you want an even number, you have half a row, half an avartana stuck. Sounds beautiful, you like it. I'm not again bothered about it. I sing it like that, I also like it. But I don't know. But the fact of the matter is, it is actually not a necessity. You could always sing it beautifully without adding a kalam still. In fact, this was I didn't even strike me. I got an arbitrary email one day after I sang it in a concert. A lady who wrote to me and said, your Nupalika was rubbish. So then she gave me she wrote this in saying that we should not be sung like this. What is you're singing? I was first miffed because that's all I've been doing sung for 80 years and she only thought of me to write that. She probably should write that to Adipodi, Mathuramani and everybody else. But anyway. Well, anyway. Yeah, probably that's a good point. So, I was there, but you know, actually she was right. I mean, to be very honest, she was right.
So she didn't give the solution?
No, but I knew the solution once I saw it was wrong. I realized the solution was very simple. If I sang, Nanu Nadachi Vachi Tivo Na Pranana Nanupa. Doesn't sound bad, exactly. See? So, perception. So there can be compositions which have three notes. So I don't think we should have any, that it's a lesser composition in any fashion. It's after all musical creation. It is not about either mathematical perfection or saying poetry form should be only 2, 4, 8. It's not about that. It's a musical creation. So Pallavi has three forms.